In this video, I am going to discuss the clinical manifestations of the renal diseases. The first of all, I will discuss the azotemia. What is azotemia? In azotemia, there is decrease in the GFR along with the increase in the blood, urea, nitrogen and the creatinine levels. The causes of the azotemia are the pre-renal causes, the renal causes and the post-renal causes. When I talk about the pre-renal causes, it includes the hypoperfusion of the kidney, include the cirrhosis of the liver, congestive heart failure, shock volume depletion. When I talk about the renal azotemia, when there is a damage in the renal parenchyma, and the post-renal azotemia, when there is an obstruction to the urinary outflow, it is known as a post-renal azotemia. Now comes to the uremia. The uremia is basically the azotemia, but when the azotemia present with the clinical signs and symptom, it is known as the uremia. Uremia present with a number of the endocrine and the metabolic disorders resulting from the renal damage. For example, the uremic gastroenteritis, the peripheral neuropathy and the fibrinous pericarditis. Now come to the nephritic syndrome. What is nephritic syndrome? It's a renal disease manifest by the grossly visible hematuria, microscopic dysmorphic hematuria, moderate proteinuria and hypertension. It's basically due to the post-streptococcal glomerulonephritis. Now comes to the nephrotic syndrome. Nephrotic syndrome, when there is a heavy proteinuria greater than 3.5 gram per day, resulting in the hypoalbuminemia, as well as edema, hyperlipidemia, and lipidemia. What is acute kidney injury? When there is a rapid decline in the GFR from hours to the days, along with metabolic disorders, and results in the manifestation of oliguria and the anuria. It results from the glomerular, interstitial, vascular, or acute tubular injury. Now come to the CKD, chronic kidney disease. What is chronic kidney disease? When there is a diminish in the GFR less than 60 ml per minute per 1.73 meter square, it is known as the CKD for at least three months. This is the main thing. Less than 60 ml GFR for at least 3 months from any cause, or the persistent albuminuria. Then comes to the end-stage renal disease. What is end-stage renal disease? End-stage renal disease, when the GFR is less than 5% of the normal, is known as the end-stage renal disease. Now comes to the renal tubular defect. What is renal tubular defect? Is dominated by the polyuria along with the electrolyte imbalance and the nocturia. Examples are the metabolic acidosis, nephronophthisis, medullary cystic disease, nephrogenic diabetes mellitus, cystinuria, renal tubular acidosis, or acquired renal tubular defect known as the lead nephropathy. Now comes to the urinary tract obstruction. It either due to the kidney stones or due to the tumors. It manifested by the characterized by the bacteriuria and the pyuria. Bacteriuria, the bacteria present in the urine, and the pyuria, presence of the leukocytes in the urine. It may be symptomatic or the asymptomatic. It involves only the kidney, it is known as the pyelonephritis. What involves the bladder, this is known as the cystitis. Now come to the nephrolithiasis. This is the nephrolithiasis. What is nephrolithiasis? Nephrolithiasis is the renal stones. How it manifests? It will be manifested by the spasm of the severe pain, or the renal colic, or the hematuria.